Hi friends, we have been reading a lot of drugs acting on the respiratory system, including the mucolytics, the expectorants, the antitussives, the bronchodilators, the respiratory stimulants, and the gases acting useful for the respiratory system. But when we come to the bovine therapy, when we are treating cows, let us see how much we are using these drugs. So first we talk of the mucolytics. The mucolytics help break down and remove mucus from the respiratory tract, aiding breathing in pneumonia and bronchitis cases. Pneumonia and bronchitis are really common in cattle also. But are we using the mucolytics? The mucolytics, commonly available mucolytics for cattle is bromhexine. Bromhexine facilitates mucus clearance. Sometimes it is combined with antibiotics, and the dose for cattle is 0.25 to 0.5 milligram per kg body weight. Then another mucolytic that is really available and you can use, because bromhexine is not readily available at many places, so you can use the, although it's an off-label use, you can use acetylcysteine. Acetylcysteine is a mucolytic and antioxidant used for, and it can be used for toxicities like nitrate poisoning. The dose is 70 milligram per kg orally with water. And the acetylcysteine and acetylcysteine is readily available as a human drug, and you can use it as an off-label at places where off-label use of the drugs is not prohibited. So you can use mucinac is the product which is available as a human product, and you can use it in cattle. Then another mucolytic is ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is readily available, and the dose for cattle is 100 to 200 milligram per kg body weight, given orally mixed with feed or water. And you can use nebulization with steam. The practical use of all these is very limited, except you can use N-acetylcysteine and you can use them in bronchopneumonia. But in pulmonary edema, do not use ammonium chloride or the N-acetylcysteine, because there in those cases the corticosteroids combined with antibiotics and diuretics are better option. Then antitussives or cough suppressants, we rarely use any cough suppressant for cattle, because coughing is a natural protective mechanism to clear the secretions. So suppressing it is not recommended, especially for cows. However, in some cases of persistent painful coughing, mild antitussives may be given. Then respiratory stimulants. A lot of respiratory stimulants have been mentioned, but these drugs stimulate breathing and are occasionally used in neonatal calves or during anesthetic recovery. The commonly used respiratory stimulants for cattle are Doxapram. Doxapram or caffeine. Doxapram can be administered to calves as a sublingual dose, or maybe it may be given intravenously at the dose rate of 0.5 to 1 milligram per kg body weight, slow IV injection or sublingual placement. Then it can be repeated if needed after 15 to 20 minutes. The most commonly used medicine for respiratory problems, a respiratory drug used for respiratory problems in cattle is the bronchodilator. And a injection which is readily available and most commonly used by most clinicians is deriphyline. Deriphyline is a combination of vitophyline, a rapid acting bronchodilator, and theophyline, a sustained bronchodilator. It is used in cattle for bronchospasm, pneumonia, and allergic respiratory conditions. The dose for cattle is 8 to 10 milligram per kg body weight, IV or IM. It can be repeated after 12 to 24 hours as per your need. And it, in severe cases, it may be repeated earlier also. It can be given IM, but for faster action, you need to administer it IV. Then the last is oxygen therapy. Oxygen therapy is rarely, if ever, used for cattle, and it should be, it can be given through a nasal cannula, and 4 to 6 liters of oxygen can be given to cattle, and especially for suppressed calves, one can use oxygen therapy, especially for the neonatal calves, one can use the oxygen therapy. Most commonly used drugs, you all know, the antibiotics, the corticosteroids, and the anti-inflammatories and anti-allergics, they are more commonly used. But since we have read so many drugs, I thought it would be useful for you to recapitulate and learn all these drugs. See you in our next video. Kindly share, like, and subscribe. GNP Sir. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.